Hey beautiful people, it's your girl Asriman Kongla. If you are new to this channel, thank you for joining me and please do stick around. And if you are a returnee, welcome back and please do enjoy the story. And if this is your second, third, fourth time and you haven't subscribed, like, what are you waiting for? Please do subscribe, please, because I know you like me, because I like you, so do the things, man. Anyway, so today I decided to tell you one of this has to be the most embarrassing story ever, and this is the reason why I don't drink. And many of my friends don't like the fact that I don't drink, because we like to think that the only way we can have fun is when we are drunk, because you let loose and all of that, but we can still have fun. So anyway, let's get to this video. So it's London for me, right? It's like Vegas. So you know the famous saying, what happened in Vegas stays in Vegas. So with me, what happens in East London stays in East London. But sometimes these things like to follow me back to Cape Town. I don't like that. So we decided to go out, just have a chilled girls' day, if there's even such a thing. So we went to a restaurant in town. I think it's in Oxford Street, Oxford, isn't it? I think so. Not sure, but I'm not gonna mention the restaurant's name because you might know it and you might know the person I'm talking about. So no, we're not about that life here. So anyway, we went to this restaurant. It was a nice, cozy place, né? So we were busy having our meal, right? While we're busy eating, okay, you know, as girls, busy taking snaps, looking cute for the gram. Oh, I'm with the love of my life, because I mean, we're that close. So we're taking pictures and having a nice time, like a nice chill talk. We're having our cocktails. It was nice, you know, because I get to see my cousin like once a year, and when we see each other, we go all out. So it was that thing, yeah, bro. And while we're busy eating, we noticed that there's like a guy walking around like in the place, and we were like, oh, maybe that's like the manager, just because he looked like he's like busy sorting things out, checking if everything is okay, like what managers basically do. And my cousin was like, oh yeah, maybe it is. And he was kind of cute, shame, he was very cute. And then I noticed him staring at me, and then it was awkward, because I'm a shy person. If like I meet you for the first time and I don't know who you are, I'm very shy. So I'm like, why is he looking at me? This is so awkward. I'm like, okay. And then my cousin was like, nah, maybe it's just looking at people, like people that who are around, yeah. So I was like, oh, okay, cool. And then he left. Then he came for the second time. Now things really got weird, because it was like he is staring at me. I'm like, what do I do? I can't even eat now, because okay, stop, please don't look at me. And then he left. I was like, okay, acuerdo. Anyway, then a waiter came, and then she had like a piece of paper with her, and she's like, the manager is asking for your number. I'm like, what? She's like, shh, don't be loud. I'm like, what do I do? I this has never happened before. I don't know what to do. And my guy's like, hey, bro, bala, right, your number. I'm like, huh? I'm like, I don't know about this decision, but here goes nothing. And I wrote down my number. Not even a minute later, I get a message. Hey, it's whatever, whatever. I saw you sitting there and you're really looking beautiful. I'm like, sure. Okay. I responded. I was like, oh, thank you. And he was like, I'd like to know you. I'd like to get to know you. I'm like, yeah. I was not comfortable, because yeah, man, it's uncomfortable. Now a lot of things are coming to my mind, like, hey, what if this guy's watching us with cameras? What if there was a lot of what ifs? I'm thinking so much, and my cousin was like putting me at ease, like, no man, relax, you know, just go with the flow, it's December, you know. So I was like, let's see where this is gonna go. So okay, we had our meal, had a few drinks, and then we left. So when I got home, and then he started messaging me again, asking me, when am I gonna be available? And I'm like, I don't want to meet this guy. No, I'm not interested. But my cousin's like, it's December, let's have fun. I'm like, I always let loose in East London. Not let loose like that, but I'm always, you know, with nursing, it's a lot of work. You don't get free times. I don't have holidays. So December is like the only holiday that I really have. So let me have fun, man. So I was like, okay, let's see where this goes. And then I was like, my cousin's like, okay, remember, don't be too available. So, and say, Kuti, you may be available tomorrow, like, to show that you're desperate. Just maybe give him like a few days, nyana, and then, yabo. So I think it was like Monday when we went to his restaurant, and then I said I'm gonna be available on Friday because we don't want to seem desperate or like we are too available, you know. I hate these mind stuff. Anyway, so Friday came. Now we had to doll up and look cute because we are going out, and he asked my cousin to come with her because he's also bringing a friend. So that made me comfortable, because at least there's someone I know, right? And I'm not used to him. I don't know him. I only saw him once. So at least if there's my cousin, which I trust, things are going to be better. And I wasn't going to go if I was going to go alone. No, 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 I wasn't. Anyway, we went to Buccaneers. If you live in East London, you don't even have to live in East London to know Buccaneers. Buccaneers is like that place that you know. So we went there, we had a buffet, we had our drinks. Yeah, we had a lot of drinks. A lot. What did we have? So many things. We had tequila shots. We had the usual, which is JC LaRue. I don't know how many bottles we drank. We had, what is this, Bomb something? Don't even remember the name. We had pink tonic, gin, whatever. Guys, the only thing that I knew was JC LaRue. Es nizing to, dani gazaz. But I went with the flow because I didn't want to seem like, agazinto. I don't. Yeah, I didn't know alcohol, but I didn't want to seem like that person, you know, with pressure and all of that stuff. But anyway, I drank, and now things started becoming a blur. That's when I knew, bah, ooh, girl, you are in for it. And then I remember snippets of the evening after I really drank, and I just passed out. And now I'm the person, I can drink, okay, I think it's because I'm so used to drinking JC LaRue, and if the percentage is so low, so when I had those things, I wasn't used to them. So I think like my system was like, hey, what it is now, what is this? So I couldn't handle it, so I passed out. That's what I think. I don't remember much of what happened that night, but I am glad I woke up at home. But I do remember the guy, we went outside Buccaneers and he was talking to me, then he started kissing me, and I was not having it. That I remember, I was not having it, because I'm like, this guy is like so old. He was really old, and now I thought we just going there to have fun, because that is what he said. Kuti, no, it's December, so we're just gonna have fun, you know. So in my mind, I'm like, this is not the fun that I signed up for. So I know some of you are thinking, but what did you expect? Ooh, what did you expect? But no, you don't need to do ezinyizinto. You can just have fun, go, like, I know some people that will just go out with people and have fun, and that's that. You don't need to do ezinyizinto. No, man, I was not about that life, and I was not having it, and I was like, I want to go inside, because no, this is not gonna happen. And he was apologizing, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to do what I did, didn't mean to kiss you. And my dad, I'm like, are you sure you didn't mean to do it? But anyway, we went inside, and I was like, I'm not gonna focus on what happened outside, I'm just gonna have fun, just enjoy the evening, try to enjoy it, even though, yay, my receptors, my neurons were a bit slow, you know. Like, the reflexes were really, really slow, because wow. But I remember dancing with my cousin, and then blank again. I don't know what happened. And when I woke up, I had, for the first time in my life, I had a hangover. And it was the worst thing in the world. The worst thing ever. I couldn't eat, couldn't drink anything. I was weak. And I used to, when I drank, I never ever had a hangover before. And it was the first time, and I didn't know what the teeny man. And I remember, I feel like that was torture though. We went out again, now to like a restaurant, and we had pizza. Oh, it smelled so nice, but I couldn't eat it because I felt like throwing up every time it came close to my mouth. So that was the worst day. The next day, Musa up. Ask me. Was the worst. I also remember, Wuti, we were at a hotel, but I remember my cousin saying that we're not going to sleep there, so they need to Uber for us. And one thing, we always have a backup plan. We always have money, so if anything happens, we can Uber ourselves. We make sure of that. Make sure, Wuti, the batteries on our phones are full, if not half, so that we can call or do something. We always make sure, Wuti, that happens. We have a plan, because things can go down, and you don't want to be stuck somewhere with no plan, nothing. So we always make sure when we go out, we sorted. So I remember she saying, no, there was like a huge fight, and I was like, yeah, there was a huge fight, but no, we're not sleeping here. And then they were like, okay, it's fine. And I like the fact that they didn't, if we said something, they agreed. They weren't those people like, you're gonna see, what you're gonna do, you're gonna have your own way. If we asked, okay, can this happen, and then they were like, okay, it's fine. So when she asked them if we could leave, they agreed. So I was like, okay, at least they're good people in that sense. Okay, fine, we left. I remember getting inside the house, and I threw up on my cousin's shoe. Imagine. But she was so nice. And also, I'm not gonna call her rude, but she took pictures of me, which I didn't like, and she didn't want to delete them, so that was not cool. And yo, I look terrible in those pictures. I was sloshed. Oh, but yeah. So I decided that day that, no man, that's not the life that I want for myself. It's not me. It wasn't me. I felt like, no man, this is not what I want with my life. I can do without alcohol, you know. It's not the end of the world if I don't drink. So, and when I'm in Cape Town, I never drink. I only drank when I was in East London. So, I mean, for the whole year, I'm not drinking, which means that I can live without alcohol and be like a normal person. Be like me, and, you know. So, I don't need it. Because of, yeah, man, I just felt like I put myself in like an awkward situation where a lot of things could have gone wrong. And I was like, no, I don't want that ever. So that happened 2 years ago, and ever since I haven't really drank, and I'm so proud of myself. And even when I'm in East London last year, I didn't drink at all. So I'm really proud of myself. And I just want people to understand that you don't need to drink in order for you to have fun. You can let loose, you know, without having to drink, because people think that you express yourself better when you're drunk. No. Mm-mm. Maybe some people who are like uptight, but I'm genuinely a talkative person, so I can let loose without having to drink. So that's, yeah. Oh, almost forgot. So that happened, and then the guy messaged me that day when the next day after we went out, and I told him how I felt, and he was like, oh, I'm so sorry that I put you in that position, blah blah blah. But we're like, no. And oh, he asked me if we could go out or like see each other. I was like, no, we are already out. I was like, okay, can I see you the following day? So I was like, oh, my word. I was like, oh, okay, cool. And then he came. And then we apologized. And I was like, oh, my word, you were like bad, bad, bad. And I was like, yeah, I don't need you to tell me that because I know. And he was like, yeah, but okay, I don't need to drink. We can just like chill, go out and have fun without having to drink. Because I told him, nah, I'm not drinking again. I just don't want that to happen again, you know. So I was like, no, it's fine, he understands, because not like alcohol is not for everyone, and I know it's not for me. No. So cool, we went to Ngqamakwe, my mom's home, for Christmas. We always go there for Christmas. So he asked me, what am I doing for Christmas? I was like, no, I'm going to my mom's home for Christmas. And I was like, oh, okay, cool. Because he's also going to be with his family for Christmas. I was like, yay. So happy. And I was really not interested in seeing him or talking to him. Because after that weird kiss, I was like, this is not what I signed up for. I didn't want... Sorry guys, my sister she's a lot, so I think you can hear her crying. So I was like, this is not what I signed up for. And then I came back, I think we came back from Ngqamakwe on the 30th, and then I had to come back to Cape Town because I had clinicals in Jan, like first week of Jan, so I had to come back early. And then he messaged me and was like, oh, are you back yet? And I was like, I'm on my way to Cape Town. And oh, he sent me essays. Ah, how could you do that to me? You didn't have the decency to tell me that you're leaving. What? I'm like, all right, not that. Like, is he okay? Because he has a wife, he has a child. I got to find out because I did research. Because he didn't have a ring. But I did research, he's married, he has a child or children, and what, and his age, he was like my mom's age, and I was like, no. And he threw a tantrum, like, what, a 15-year-old kid, but I thought we had a life ahead of us. I wanted to spoil you and do all these good things for you. I'm like, hey, we're not, hey, spoil your wife, spoil your kids, and leave me alone, please do. Blocked his number, deleted it. I'm like, it's London. Guys, it's London. Yo, you can lose yourself there. You can definitely lose yourself if you are, I'm not gonna say you're a weak person, but I hope you understand, but it's easy to lose yourself in this London. And I was like, no, that's not the life that I want, because I'm not exposed to Ezo Zinto in Eastern Cape, I mean in Cape Town. And I don't want to be that type of person. So I decided that no, I'm never ever putting myself in that situation. If an old person approaches me, no, don't even come close to me. No. Back then it was just a thing of, okay, he just said that he just wants to have fun, you know. So I was like, okay, fun. Gandhi! The fun was something else. And he even bought a present. He took a picture, like a nice necklace. I'm like, hey, give that to your wife or your child. I don't care. I do not want it. Thank you very much. So that's the end of the video. I hope you guys learned something, because I definitely did. So do not forget to like, subscribe, follow your girl on Instagram at @akume_mkonce and on Twitter at @akume_mkonce. Do not forget to subscribe, like, comment, share, and do all the things. Bye bye. See you on the next video.